Ready to go. Welcome to the second draw at the Nova Scotia Curling Provincials. We are watching a women's game. Jessica Daigle is playing Mackenzie Mitchell, and we're on sheet two at the Halifax Curling Club. Our event is sponsored by Ocean Contractors for the men's and the Scotties, of course, Kruger for the women. At the end of the weekend, we're going to declare Nova Scotia representatives for the 2024 Montana Brier and Scotties Tournament of Hearts. As I mentioned, we're watching Jessica Daigle's team, who has Hammer, playing Mackenzie Mitchell. I'm Mary Sue Radford, and I'm here with the one-armed bandit.
Hi, I'm Teresa Breed.
And we're excited to be here, front row seats, watching this game. The teams did the draw to the button, and Team Daigle had the better draw. So they're starting off. This is, for both of them, this is their first game in the event. Kate Fitzgerald is the lead on Team Mitchell. Two of the players on Team Mitchell are from Newfoundland, originally from Newfoundland.
Already, yeah. The action is heating up here, Mary Sue. Right in the first end.
Oh, I think that's just Brent McDougal over there.
Good, Kate.
Making sure his lungs still work.
Roll to the wing for Kate. And Katie, you'll recognize, I'm sure people will recognize Katie, who's from Vandenborg, who's from Fredericton, New Brunswick. You'll remember her from the Andrea Kelly team. She's our out-of-province curler on Daigle's team. Strong front end for Daigle.
Yeah, both teams are playing a pretty wide-open end so far. First game of the event for both teams, so just getting comfortable with the ice in the first end, and I'm sure we'll see the action heat up once they get comfortable with the speed and the paths of the rocks.
Second on Team Mitchell is Sarah Chater. She is from St. John's, Newfoundland, but she's going to SMU, and she's a fourth-year finance student.
Mine's good.
Oh, another finance person in curling. What a surprise. A high ratio of finance and engineers.
There we go. Here comes Lindsay Burgess. Lindsay's 24 and she's a geology student at Dal. She was born in Williams Lake, BC, but we all know she's from Truro, Nova Scotia.
10-5.
From the Burgess curling family dynasty. Is the third in Team Daigle.
10.
Originally from Bridgewater, Nova Scotia. Well, I'm not, I got that wrong. That's Sarah again, sorry.
Get through.
Sarah Chater. Lindsay's getting ready to throw.
Right now they all have black uniforms. Very confusing.
Ponytails from the back, you see a black uniform and a ponytail.
And lots of sponsors. Shout out to all these companies supporting these teams.
Yeah. Wouldn't happen without support from sponsors, that's for sure.
Yep, hold it. Clean. Yeah. 10-5. Work. Yep, you got it.
No. Okay, that's good.
We have another women's game on sheet one.
9-8.
It's Adams Moss is playing the. I'm not sure who they say. Do they say? It is Team Smith, sorry. Yeah, it's Joe Brothers throws hand.
Clean.
Clean.
Okay, whoa. Kate. Her Kate.
You're good.
Good.
That's it's a great format. Every game time there's two men's games and two women's games going on, so it's great to see get a variety.
Yeah, and new format for this event, the modified triple knockout, which shortens the play time, which is good, and also lets those clubs that are, you know, have offered up their services to host an event. They know in the end date it. They know when the final is. It's better planning for clubs for sure.
Yeah, so eight teams in each of the men's and women's events, and they will play a triple knockout, so meaning you keep playing until you lose three games, and then you're out.
Mine's good.
And the top four teams will make the playoffs on the weekend in a cage playoff system where first-ranked team plays a second-ranked team, and the winner gets a bye to the final. The fourth-place team plays a third-place team. The winner of that plays the loser of the 1-2 game in the semifinal. And then the finals all happen, so the women's final is Sunday at 2 p.m. and the men's is Sunday at 6 p.m. And you can catch the action live and in person here at the Halifax Curling Club.
10-5! Yep.
Or you'll also be able to join us on the stream.
So many great things happening at Halifax Curling Club during this event. Come on down, the kitchen's open, the bar's open, there's great viewing. We have terrific ice at the Halifax Curling Club.
Yeah, just prior to this draw, we had the opening ceremonies. And
10. You got it. Feels quick.
Tomorrow night there will be, Friday night and Saturday night there will be live music both nights, so you can enjoy some great music while you're watching some great curling.
Yeah, get out of the house. Come on down.
Yes, COVID is over. Come on down. Party like it's 2019.
This is Mackenzie Mitchell's first shot. She's from Cornerbrook, Newfoundland.
We also have Family Day Saturday from 10 to 3 p.m. So those of you out there who maybe have never tried curling, you can stop in the club and try floor curling. So you don't have to worry about slipping and falling on ice like I did when I broke my arm a couple of weeks ago. You can safely try curling from the floor. And then for kids, there'll be face painting and snacks, and the kitchen and bar will be open as well for the adults.
I'm looking forward to watching the sweeping combo here, Lindsay and Katie. Both great sweepers. Pretty much most of the play this end has just been down the center line. Keeping it simple. Katie working to make that curl and make contact but roll out.
Straight draw. Right there.
Yeah, my team played on the sheet in the previous draw, and so lots of nice curl.
What are we thinking?
Lower weight shots, the draws and the board weights, but definitely once you step the weight up, it will run fairly straight from outside in. So, you know, we just saw that in that shot where they were trying hard to hit and roll to the wing, but just it ran a little straighter than they expected in the long term.
Now, these set of rocks, these would be the provincial curling rocks, aren't they? Yeah, yeah.
No extension.
Kate Callahan and Sarah Chater. You'll notice Kate Fitzgerald's in the house. Jessica just threw this, so she'll be familiar with the path.
Just easy peel.
you'll get a little bit more finish here, just where we're in that good stuff.
That's great. We'll try to make sure we can listen to the curlers whenever we get the chance. For Daigle, they'll take hammer to the second end. First game and your first in the spiel, you're not going to take too many chances in the first end or maybe even the second end, but then
yeah, I would say like that.
Get your comfort level up.
Yeah, let's see if they're ready to go here, whether she calls a guard or not.
Kate Fitzgerald is a student at Dow. Her favorite curler, female curler, is Alina Petz.
Excellent choice.
Yep, and Kate is also a Canadian champion. She won the Canadian Junior Championships in 2022.
So Kate's recently out of the junior leagues, and this is her first women's provincial.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Yeah, very exciting.
Keening up here, so it's.
Yeah, I don't have my watch on me, but this afternoon's game, it was running around 15, and nice speed.
Yeah. It keens up pretty quickly, too. Looking for the corner guard here.
Okay, Team Daigle's ready to go. Playing a guard.
Katie Vandenberg, she's a nurse.
Line's good.
I think it should be all there.
Hold the line.
Placement
good
of that
spot,
guard.
Good.
This is one of those shots as a team, you know, if you know, you're sort of your set play, you know what you're going to play here. You hit the point there, and I'm going to throw to the open side.
Yeah, Team Mitchell's happy to play conservative for now. It's a long, this is probably the first 10-end game these teams have played in this season.
Yeah, that's
most
correct.
Most of the Bonspiel
season
is all 8-end games, so it does make for a longer game, so you don't need to be as aggressive early. You can be patient until you're comfortable with the ice.
That's true. There is a real change to the flow of the game. It's much more of an adjustment than it used to be because you really don't play 10-ends any other time during the year. And for these women, it was, an open event, so there was no qualifier to get here. The men did have a qualifier. From Digby. Looking for the draw around the corner. Sweep by Marley Powers. I bet that mixed doubles is, you know, the transition for her. She would have not done a whole lot of sweeping before, but with mixed doubles, I bet she's doing a lot more. Playing the chase here. Counting the rocks, that's the risk of playing that weight on that shot. You might consider playing pack weight there to, you know, to manage that a little bit.
Yeah, definitely. Take a little bit more ice and bring your sweepers into play.
It was hard for us to tell at this angle, but it, you know, it was well guarded. Again, we're playing with a rule with, I don't know what the name of the rule is, but don't move the rock off the center line. Is that what the rule is called? Yeah. You can't move the rock off the center line until the sixth rock comes down. That's. But normally we don't see that rule come into play until the last few rounds where it seems to make the most difference. By Jessica, where she says, I'm just going to try to fit anyone around this corner. Nice shot by Lindsay Burgess.
Good call. What was that long?
He's sweeping on this Daigle, too. Those rocks were set up for a double, so that would be the one thing.
Close. Yep. Hard. Good.
Corner guard or hit and roll? Especially since it's the second end of your first game. You know, if you were really sure and you were really sure of the ice and the weight and everything,
10, 5, 11,
you
can't
go for sure.
You gotta go, Marley. You gotta go. You're holding it. Keep going. Go. Go right to it.
Hard.
Right to it. You're holding it. Keep going.
Marley, every inch. Every inch.
Keep
hard.
Going. Go. Hard. Good sweep.
Yeah. Great communication during the sweeping. I love how Katie was encouraging Marley and sort of keeping her updated about progress, if you will. Kate Callahan and turn drop looking at the double.
No,
Sarah.
It's got a curl.
It's by all of it.
Okay.
See what she did with that.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
Both yeah, again, once you're up the weight,
I think
it
should be the same.
It's in shot. I'm pretty sure.
Too
much ice or maybe a combination.
I wonder if Sophia's watching this game. What do you think? If she is, Susu says hi, Sophia. There's a good chance.
whoa.
Sophia's getting ready for bed, that's the thing. Just
good.
Come on to the back.
Nine.
Yeah,
this is last night.
Sophia's what, two?
Yeah, she's just over two. Yeah.
You can never start too young.
No, you can. That's right. Control weight here by Marley.
Nine?
scoring update. So on sheet one, Smith versus Adams Moss, they blank the first end.
Yep.
And it looks like they've got some rocks in play in the second end, so I think we'll see some score. Not sure what's happening on sheet eight. I don't think I see any. Oh, yeah, it's a blank end on sheet eight, and that is Manuel versus McDougal. And on sheet four, it is Steele versus Thompson, is it? 2-0 for Thompson.
Whoa! I might have took a chunk out that time.
Okay. She does, okay. She stays for second shot.
Should be just as fast here. Yeah.
See what the ice they're taking, this nice curl.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, good opportunity here for Jessica to get a feel for her draw weight. This open draw to the rings.
Full 12.
That's pretty keen if they said 15.5 is okay.
Oh, wow.
You got it. Okay, T-line's good here.
So they benefited from getting to, you know, fresher ice there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Kenzie Mitchell looking to...
Okay, I'll throw this one better.
Is that the option of, you know, partially rolling behind her rock?
Okay. Are we trying to roll my way a touch, or...?
No, I think you rolled to the open side, maybe.
Nope, she said the open side.
You got it.
Could go under if you want.
Up to you. Who's shot? Like,
then.
Shot.
Then.
Okay.
Maybe you do. Hey, roll our way! Yeah. Yeah. That way. Yeah.
You got it, Mac. You got it.
I like this call. The roll's shorter, number one, than a bigger roll. Potentially make the shot a lot harder for Jessica.
Yeah, definitely. And they've seen a bunch of rocks go down here,
yeah,
so.
That's true.
I like your chances
right
of making
push.
It.
Hard! Push right up, Sarah. Go, 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 go.
Hard! Wait, they're right there. Through.
Go, 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 go.
Any
go, go, go.
Oh, good. Yeah, good effort. Yeah. Jessica tightening up her broom compared to Mackenzie. Those are slightly different throws. Jessica also has a really late release on the rock. She's
ten.
She's so close to the rock, I think she might be over it. But she does release it very
quickly. Keep going.
Wow.
Oh, she got.
Okay.
I don't know. I'm not sure.
What? I got out of that one. So we got out of that one. The first one I threw, did I just have to let it out? Yeah, and okay. Where you let it go?
like,
dude, didn't just kind of bit
like you let go at the rock. It was just that one and just went out the whole way.
Also, you're throwing it, you know, when you're throwing the outside of the sheet at the start of a game, you always feel like you got to err on having a little more than a little less. So.
Yeah, a little more weight, maybe a little more rotation on this round.
Yeah.
Just missed it by an inch.
Oh my goodness, there's Kerry McLean. I haven't seen him all year.
Yeah, that's Team Steel.
Know,
so
yeah.
That's a new team that formed this year. So. Yeah, nice to see them out here. We'll keep an eye on their game.
Yeah, it's great. Great teams, great games going on out there. Again, don't come on down to Halifax Grilling Club. Three draws on Thursday and Friday, 9, 2, and 7. For sure,
still
whichever
like
draw
17?
You come to, you're going to see a great
75?
Game.
Okay.
Katie's
oh, yeah.
A southpaw.
I think the speed that we can make up with sweeping. Like, I do too, yeah.
I can say I didn't notice in the first few hands. I don't know why I just noticed now. She is a left-hander. Nice throw.
There's so much action.
Whoa,
here.
Whoa.
I know, yeah.
Line's good.
I just don't know where to look
line's
next.
Good.
There's so much
line's
going
good.
On.
Marley!
I didn't notice it either.
Marley, when you can! You gotta go, both of you. Gotta go for weight. Gotta go! Keep going to split center. Split center, split center! Marley, got a touch. Good.
They're trying to get that rock on center line because Team Mitchell can't move it off center until the sixth rock is thrown. So it takes the tick shot until later.
Line's good.
T line back four.
Yeah, we're definitely not seeing as many tick shots called as used to be. Again, these teams are pretty accurate at being able to put them on the center line, so when it's touching the center line, it can't be really from playing to the sixth block.
And first error there by Kate, a little heavy. Katie will have the opportunity to try to throw top house. Behind the rock, we're good.
A little bit for line.
All close.
Line! Really hard!
Well, we have an update on the scoring sheet one. So
yeah,
team
line.
Adam,
line's good.
Adams Moss has
switch,
scored
switch,
one.
Switch,
so they
switch.
Lead Team Smith by a score of 1-0.
Just Lindsay. You got to bury it.
Sheet
you got to bury
eight.
It.
I missed what happened there, but I think McDougal was drawing to score three. They haven't posted the score yet, so I'm going to assume he made it. It's probably 3-0.
It was a great shot by Katie, but perfectly placed.
Oh, well done.
Yeah. It's very clear about where she wants that eye.
Really great communication by this team. You can hear them having that conversation back and forth between the sweepers and the house.
Yeah, they really, really do.
Keep going, Kate.
They don't communicate too, you know, it's not too much talking and it's not too little. I think they have a great, the very effective.
Take the long on mine.
Communication.
On this one.
So now. Staggered guards are not helping her, so she's good.
That is just a quick update on sheet four. Team Steele has scored two in the second end to tie up the game versus Team Thompson.
Good, 6-9.
That's a good result for Team Mitchell because it does force Jessica to play the back raw. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, she's going hard for a steal. If she doesn't make a great guard.
Yeah, really nice. Double roll to the corner.
Yeah.
Yeah, I kind of like
There's
that more.
With those, the guard without not having the gaps between the two guards. I was looking across the country looking to see when other people are doing their playdowns. Most provinces are doing them for next weekend. Like in a week from now, but Saskatchewan and New Brunswick and Nova Scotia are doing that.
No,
I didn't check
yes
up.
Yes, lives. Two.
But we also have Jennifer Jones
one,
and
two.
Pretty
high.
Lives. Scotties. By virtue of CTRS points, so we know that those two teams will be there, which will make it
fun. Sit down. Okay.
Get already. It's off to a great field. So that's an overcurl guard.
Yeah, I did hear on a podcast that UConn had held their championships, I think, last weekend, and Bailey Scotland's team represent UConn. So Bailey is just out of junior.
Yeah, that's great.
So she's competed at many Canadian juniors, and I think competed at the Canadian mixed doubles last year.
Oh, right.
As well. So, yeah, so it was a nice new face out of UConn for the women's.
Because I don't think Winnie Wood has a team.
No, that was kind of big news that Winnie unfortunately couldn't field a team this year. Which will open up a spot for the CTRS team to go and replace to the Scotties.
I like another guard, eh?
A good miss, if that's a good way to say it, if there's such a thing. But Jessica's got a good opportunity here to get a piece
two,
of the
three.
Center line.
Top hole! We're top hole! Top eight! Three!
Shot that's really
three.
Perfectly placed, top 4 foot.
Three, four! Four! Katie! Just Katie! Just no, 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 no! One or the other. It looked like a nice throw.
Yeah, it's so close.
A good two! Two, three! Two, three! Lindsay! Oh!
Yeah, it's two, important
Lindsay.
For Team Mitchell
two.
Now to really try and just clear
good
out from that house so they make sure that they score the same as they were objective. They really don't want to be giving up a steal.
That's an overcurled guard there. Does that leave an opportunity?
Like this?
Okay. I don't know that you can't make a play on your own. But phrase as we can.
This might work out well. Starting to boil.
I think second piece. Yeah. So I was giving there for those. I think that's close. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, just a difference in weight. Like Kate had that nice kind of a control of the weight in the first one.
Yeah.
And it curled up in that one throwing the peel. It ran very straight.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, just really important to make sure you get the right ice for the
just have piece.
Well,
yeah.
Like,
no deeper than full 12. Okay.
Time clocks are in play too at this event.
Like 15-2-ish or more?
I don't mind 15, 15-5.
15-5.
I really think we'll be able to get it there.
Yeah.
Necessarily. I don't think I'm trying to see if you can see it from the live stream, but I don't think so. But, you know, teams will be aware of that and watch how much time they have. But people are playing at a nice pace.
Yeah, so just a scoring update on sheet 8. McDougall did only get to. Not three against me, so up to nothing after two.
Top eight!
Sorry, Brent, I just expected you would have made that shot.
Six! Top eight!
I do think Brent's going to win the award for the loudest guy ever tonight.
T-line!
Yeah.
T-line!
Girl!
Six!
Gotta get up for that game.
Yeah. Short for Jessica. Hold up for the Christmas tree.
I think it's like what? Four?
Yeah, really key to just on those close stones in the house and stay in the house
there.
And then Jessica will have
to take that close. Something.
At this point,
we'll always have that on our next.
Okay.
And if I make this, you can't block both.
Yeah.
Okay. What kind of weight?
Four.
Okay.
I'd like to get like a big enough roll to kind of half tuck under that yellow.
Looked like nice weight.
Mm-hmm.
I think so.
Interesting. Take it from, I like this call.
Minimum?
Yeah, a little bit more range to get carried on this
time.
I think that's close.
Lot out here, so it'll be interesting to see.
Top four?
The challenge is the weight, I'm sure. Teams would have had, they've all had a practice time.
Yeah. Full four.
In a, you know, before their pre game practice.
Does this look like max to you?
Yeah.
Yeah. I think if you take it in there or anything.
Yeah.
I think you'll see this be 2 feet slower than the other side.
I agree.
Okay, let's make a good one here.
Good
judge. Yeah, I agree.
court.
Same as
well,
the first
bike
end.
Court.
Yeah, just like the same as your one at the first end.
Okay. Has it changed?
He's drawn go down. So they've got lots of reference points for
is
this.
Is it four?
Bike four.
Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah. You got it.
It hasn't changed, has it?
No, we're thinking same as you threw in the first.
Okay.
Pressure draw them. Scores 1-1 after three.
Yeah, really good force.
Daigle takes hammer to the fourth, which she'll be happy with. You'd be happy with hammer in the evening. And I think they'd be comfortable with the ice now saying, I think I know what it's going to do. They haven't played much center line out, but no one has. So might get an opportunity to go around
we'll
the corner.
Yeah, we'll see if Mackenzie decides to throw the guard this end. She's played more of a defensive strategy without hammer, so see if she changes tactics or whether she's happy to throw it into the forefoot and knows that probably Jessica will throw a corner. Right on sheet one, Team Smith has scored one in the third end, so we have a tie game between Smith and Adams Moss, 1-1.
Fitzgerald. First shot of the fourth end. I didn't see her call, but it looks.
Yeah, it looks like. Not laying a brush to it. I'm thinking they've called a guard.
Yeah.
Okay, game on.
Well, you know the ice is up because it does that here. You know that the when it starts curling, gets settled in. That intern has a beautiful curl. Mm-hmm.
Stop doing that.
Yeah, Dylan is right. These teams plan their whole year for this event. Their whole, you know, your curling cycle is. This is when you're hoping that it all comes together. Yeah, and they start early, you know, so you might think, oh, it's
yeah,
on the original. They've been thinking about this and working towards
gotta
this.
Gotta go! Hard line!
Yeah, depending on the different
really
teams.
Really hard line!
Summer training,
switch,
and early spiels, and traveling.
Get it off the center line, get it off the center line, get it off!
Yeah, I think Team Daigle was at it there in the spiel in Quebec, I think, in August.
Yes,
so.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I like it. Yeah, you got it.
Yes, they played, they won the curling store cash game in Metro. They played in three Stu Sells events with Colberry and Halifax, and they played in the Lady Rotunda.
Line's good!
Tommy!
Where?
Four!
Look!
Looking for weight here.
Four! Switch if you can. Okay, Kate. Hard Kate, right over. Go. Okay.
Nice draw,
nice, Kate.
Good.
Good judge. You see him back line? Easy hack.
You Kitty could hit her. You can't hit your own wall.
Whoa, Lindsay.
Actually, I don't know if it's touching, but Lindsay's working
go.
Out this curl.
Gotta go.
And right
keep
over
going.
There's like
keep
all
going.
The weights on the ground.
Keep going.
Nice weight too.
That's fine too. Well, no, there.
Scoring update on sheet two. Manuel scored two in the third end to tie the game. 2-2 versus Hector. Lots of close games.
Yeah.
Rocks and play.
Where?
Yes.
Back four.
Yeah. Okay. Yep.
Yeah, pressure
calling it. This is deep.
Whoa. Curl if you can. Hard. Right over. Huh? Go.
Stop.
Hard.
Yes,
okay.
Good.
Yeah.
Nice shot.
Sarah Chater. This is Sarah's first provincial championships playing in Nova Scotia. She's curled for 16 here, so.
No, curl! Curl!
Yeah, all you got.
Good throw.
Both of these teams have coaches. Shots out of one here, we can feel the double peeling, might even get something off that back rock, too. Nice. Lindsay Burgess is the girl to dodge.
Yes! Whoa! Yes!
She's got some heat on that one.
Oh,
yeah,
great
shot.
Go.
Great shot by Lindsay.
Great shot, Lindsay.
She's got a corner guard. She leaves a rock at the back. That's a super shot.
Yeah. Right there.
Sarah's rock! Whole family traveling to Scotland to Scotland. So, I mean, that sounds like.
Is this heavy?
That sounds amazing.
Sarah?
Okay.
Carly, of course, plays on the team, Jennifer Jones.
Sorry.
A true girl, too, who's living in Manitoba. We're just lending her to Manitoba. We're not saying they can keep her.
Yes, the lure of Nova Scotia will eventually come calling.
Yeah, so it'll be, it's the sea and our lakes and rivers and everything. Yeah, and Truro.
And the seafood.
Yeah, yeah.
Close. Yeah.
Yeah. Powers here.
And our lovely winters. We do not have the minus 50 degrees.
What are you people talking about?
Yeah, we don't
know.
That's a great roll by Morgan right behind the guard.
We're shivering at minus 5.
How much do you have?
We're not far behind the BC folks in terms of lightweights when it comes to cold weather.
I'm going to see a piece of this in the return side.
Half? Board!
You can do a lot on this ice with varying your weight, so.
Yeah, any shot is possible.
Yeah. This one. Jessica Singh. Who shot Rock and some blue still shot.
Yeah, like here, Mary Sue.
Good you with holes.
Or what are our other options there?
Yeah. So Daigle is hammer. She could draw around the corner good.
Mm-hmm.
She could draw around the corner good either way.
Mm-hmm. Oh, look how surprised she's.
10-5.
Yeah.
She's got a nice guard there, but
really
she's just keeping it simple. She does have good separation.
Go, 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 no roll, no roll.
That was great, sweet.
Good.
Mm-hmm.
Nice shot.
Go away.
Nose hit by McKenzie.
Good. Yeah, good shot. Yeah, so will Jessica choose to play the more aggressive call and go around there?
Have we shot?
The shot she just called. I feel like she's just going to play the hit based on, which I get. She's saying, I'm going to take my easy too.
Mm.
Likely to set up a double.
10.5.
So.
You don't like the draw? I don't think so. Okay.
Why make it more complicated than you have to?
Yeah, just small. Yeah.
I really like the hit weight both teams are using.
Yeah,
not overthrowing it. Manageable hit weight. In fact, everyone out there looks like they're throwing. Very controlled hit weight.
Mm-hmm.
She did set up a bit of
yeah.
A double there, but
anyway. But
I mean,
if you get the rolls, fine. If you get the
rolls,
fine.
Fine.
Yeah, I'm a little surprised she didn't go around the guard. Again, it's that first game tournament, so.
Go for the double, but if we hit and roll, that's fine too.
You got it. Should run fairly true here, I think.
Go two shots.
It's really flat.
Yeah.
This or this, but.
You got it.
Yeah, both options are there, so.
I think if you're going for the double, then you're not hitting in a similar amount of damage.
8-5! Hard zero.
I need to sweep this. There's a hole there, though, I think. There's the hole.
Yeah.
it's going to be disappointing for Mackenzie and Mitchell. That might just be an indication of sort of thinking of two shots instead of, you know, really focusing on the
one.
Am I playing the hit or am I playing the
hit? Yeah, a little bit too focused on the outcome versus just the process of hit the broom.
I think I can throw mine a bit more.
Yeah, I like that she's looking for fishing too.
She was clearly narrow, so.
I'll let you know when you're on it.
You got it.
Yeah, you called it, Mary, so she was discussing both options to the front end, where you just got to pick one, right?
Yeah.
I
understand if anyone wants to know.
They're
looking
seven,
for information. What's the play? They're not necessarily critiquing it. They do. They want to know where they want to hit it.
Six,
know,
seven.
Give us the information. And then I think as a skip, then you're starting to process more when you... You need to just shut it down and like you say, just focus on the process. Hit the broom, throw the right way.
Mm-hmm.
Nice three for Jessica Daigle. On the fourth end, they'll take a 4-1 lead against Mackenzie Mitchell going into the fifth end.
So scoring update on sheet 4, Steele is up 3-2 over Thompson, playing the fourth end. Sheet 1, Smith has stolen one the fourth end to lead Adams Moss by a score of 2-1 from the fifth end.
I want to remind everyone and I want to thank our event sponsors for these playdowns. For the men, Ocean Contractors Limited. They're our title sponsor for the Tanker Provincial. Ocean Contractors Limited is located in Dartmouth, Nova Scotia, and they've been a valued sponsor of curling events and teams from the province. In fact, they sponsored me when I was about a junior curler 100 years ago.
Did they?
Yep. Jack Fleming is Ocean Contractors, and it's anyway, and you'll know. And Kate Fitzgerald is in the Fleming family line, so we got to thank Ocean Contractors a lot for all their curling support over the years. And of course, Kruger Products. Scotties is the sponsor of the Women's Provincial Playdown. Scotties has been a sponsor of women's amateur curling for more than 40 years at the provincial and national level. And I don't know of another, you know, sporting event that has that kind of longevity in a sponsor.
I think they are the longest serving sponsor of any sporting event. Women curlers love our Scotties.
Yeah. And it's a brand you can easily, you know, when you're going to the grocery store and you can, you know, definitely
pick up your Scotties tissues.
Exactly. Be loyal to our curling sponsors.
Mm-hmm.
Are you still involved in the in the Schmerler Foundation?
I have been for many years as a board member and advisor. It's still very near and dear to my heart, but I did finally just retire from the board.
Oh, did you? Yeah.
In September.
Mine's good.
But yeah, it's a great organization and, you know, very, very closely tied with women's curler, named after 3-time Scotties champion Sandra Schmerler. In her name, and it supports babies in crisis. So they raise money to support neonatal intensive care units in hospitals
across the country. I love that part of it. I think that's so special. You know, when we were in Yarmouth curling, and remember, we were curling at the seniors, but at the event, it was Janet Murphy and Teresa went to the Yarmouth Hospital to deliver a donation. You know, you go in Sault Ste. Marie, they, you know, they received it. Like, they're just all across the country. It's, I really appreciate that. And as a donor, that's important to me. You like to see that it's going locally and you understand the impact of your donation.
Yeah, they're very generous in donating to hospitals where major curling events happen. So,
it's got a curl.
This year, with the Scotties Tournament of Hearts being in Calgary, they will be making a major donation to one of the Calgary hospitals to support neonatal care there. So it's just a really feel-good thing that all curlers get behind, and it doesn't exist without the tremendous generosity of curling fans and curling athletes across the country. It allows us to remember an incredible curling icon, Sandra Schmirler, and her family are all very involved with the foundation as well, and they're just a wonderful family.
Lindsay's just making sure she understands. Sarah was her draw around the corner guard really curled because for a second there she almost ticked the center line.
My blue is just top button, eh? That's a little too deep, personally.
Well, I was seeing the tape. I didn't realize you could see as much as you see. I don't mind what kind of weight.
Yeah, I just mean there's lots of room for us to put another one there.
You don't have to stick the shoe. Yeah, to roll to center is really good. Hack.
Really great communication again between this team to understand what the options are.
Hack.
Yep. Okay. She knows exactly what she's playing. As do the sweepers. Well. Swapped. It's a good result. Mackenzie's going to use her corner guard, and so she should. And that's why would you have a corner guard if not use it?
Good call.
Because when this goes here. It feels hard. She's got nice weight.
You're good.
Oh, nicely
good
played,
yeah. Good spot, Sarah.
That one is buried.
Good sweep.
Poked out the other side. Jessie's not going to mess around. She's going to go straight for the peel. It's Lindsay's second shot, so.
Yeah, I'm not sure you want to go chasing that and risk.
You don't need
ticking their corner into the rings when you've got a 3-point lead.
No need to gamble there.
Yeah, worst case, heel a guard up to.
Interesting, she's playing this outside in.
Yeah, I'm just thinking, is she playing just the run back?
I guess she doesn't. Yeah, she must be playing the run back. Yeah. No, I don't know.
We'll see.
No, she's not throwing.
10-5.
Yep.
A hit and roll.
Oh. 10-5. Yeah.
You know, I think she's playing the hit and roll to the center.
Yeah,
interesting.
Her.
She's trying to get us something out of it.
Yellow. Yeah.
Yep.
Nice call.
Yep. Good shot by Lindsay. I don't think there's a hole there.
Yeah, she threw that
there
one.
Might be, but.
That or hit and roll the guard.
We want to throw it back.
Turn hit and roll for Sarah, trying to replace the corner guard, open up the front.
Oh, clean it?
Yeah.
Hard! Well,
yep. Hard.
Okay.
Okay.
I do think there's definitely a hole. I mean, you have to, Jessica has to deal with that. Yeah. You're at the open rock. You're up 3.
Easy 10.
This is the safe play. using, I like their hand signals too. They've got really good hand signals.
You gotta go.
Get so loud out there and you have to rely on visual cues.
Whoa, Lindsay, go, go.
Okay. Nice shot, very nice shot. But there's an opportunity here for hit and roll for Kate Callahan. Whisker. Did you see a whisker on the guard there? Did I imagine that?
I missed it.
Yeah.
Where's the replay button?
Yeah. Or the little Netflix about 10 seconds, whatever. That one. What did they say again? They've played a lot of shows, like they're very, you know.
Yeah, very businesslike in what they're doing. There's no panic.
Yeah, and roll under.
Even if you do this.
Yeah, I'm not thinking anything like crazy, like half backs.
I like board.
So update on sheet four. So Team Steel have stolen two in the fourth end. They're up 5-1 now on Thompson.
Oh yeah.
So that game's kind of broken open a bit.
Working this. Oh, that was unlucky. Oh, I thought she had that. That was unlucky. Nice weight, nice throw. Daigle can really.
Yeah, it's right
there. Doesn't have to be a terrific guard.
That's where I gave to, like, just cross that line.
Just in between those two rocks, basically.
Okay.
Tracy, I'm feeling like, they're getting ready for the fifth end break and the pebblers are getting ready. Are you feeling like, do you think you're ever going to pebble again? The answer is no.
Have you ever pebbled, Mary Sue?
Oh, maybe once, but not like.
You got it.
Not in the recent past.
So to clarify to the listeners, I'm not a one-armed bandit. I actually decided to go out and learn how to pebble on January 2nd. And I was having a great time. It was actually really fun, and I recommend everybody try it.
Yeah.
So our awesome ice maker, Adam, was teaching me, and another woman, Kate Thompson, and we were having a grand time until I fell and broke my wrist. Bit of a freak fall. Anyways, I will be okay. Four more weeks in my cast. Right there.
This too shall pass.
Yes.
Could have been worse.
Really, there's the Halifax Curl Instagram account. They had a great photo of Adam. Did you see the photo of him pebbling and the pebbles of water in the air in his face? It was a really good action photo.
Yeah, last week was the Ice Technician Appreciation Week
or
something.
Yes. I didn't know that was a week.
Saw lots of pictures of great ice makers across the country.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah.
Oh my goodness, they work so hard, and there is quite a science behind it. I actually learned a lot. Having curled my whole life, I was kind of embarrassed that it took me so long to actually go out and try to do this, and I learned a lot. It was really interesting. So,
does it matter what temperature the water is when you pebble?
Yes.
Yeah, it does. Doesn't
yeah,
it?
You have to like take the temperature of the water, and it is hot. The water's hot. I never knew the water was hot.
When it hits the center line, I think it's gonna go. So.
I think she's going to try to maneuver this.
I think that's holding up pretty true.
Okay. With the right weight, you can get through here. She saw Kate's a similar path from Mackenzie. Oh boy, that was close.
Oh my goodness.
That made me nervous. Well, that's a great
She
shot.
Wanted the roll. That's why that's she fun. Was sweeping. Yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Maybe it was a little quieter weight than she had called. That's why she
was
sweeping.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. What a Ooh. Shot.
Yeah, that was great. Great execution.
Skipper's deuce is in play unless Jessica can make a nice freeze here.
Yeah, this is T-line.
And even, Jessica can hold her to one if she gets a full four for
here.
Yeah.
Pretty fresh spot. I don't
Unless
think
she can play that out turn to that.
Should be real close.
And there's Speak of Adam. There he is. There's the devil right there.
Yeah, kind of like what you threw on your draw down
that's
this
true.
Way.
She might be able to play the out turn hit through the hole for two, right?
Depending on, how deep Jessica goes.
Lock on a good one here.
You got it.
They're sweeping for right
there,
Jessica.
Gotta go, Lindsay. Gotta go, Lindsay.
Keep going, Lindsay.
Hurt.
Keep going.
Great shot.
Good throw.
Yeah.
Good shot.
Good sweep. Good shot.
Good sweep.
I'm
like here? You think that's close? Okay.
Do you think you can make this shot? You just have to be close to the yellow
just
one.
Yeah.
And you would have enough room,
I think,
to be.
You think the shot through the hole is there?
I think this shot is easier than the shot through the hole.
Okay.
I don't think this side's been played quite as much.
But it shouldn't be like overly slow.
No.
Like probably like 3 feet more.
I don't even think that. I'm
okay.
Yeah, there's certainly lots of curl in here, so.
Yes.
She gets the right weight. She should be able to get to the edge of the forefoot.
Okay.
Good talk there about how much
Can I throw the
to
same
throw?
As what I throw on that side? And you just sweep it? Okay.
Big shot here for Mackenzie. Make a big difference to get her two here.
We need the blue. Hard line. We need the blue. Get a five.
Oh, she was so close.
Yeah,
I think she would have. Yeah,
close. Really?
Yeah, definitely. I think she had that if she just.
Too bad.
Yeah. Nice throw.
Okay, so they'll score one. So Daigle will be up two with playing six, and they're going into a fifth end break. 5 minute break.
5 minute break. We'll take a little break and be back.
Thank you.
some snacks?
Oh, no. No.
Oh, I know. I'm a doll.
Terry
fan.
Made me shepherd's pie for tonight.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's it. Sorry.
Thank you.
Honestly, Katie sent me this picture last night. It's nice. Sophia sometimes takes different things in the crib. And so this is from the monitor. It's a creepy looking doll. She's done that before. It's just like one thing. It's just like a creepy. It's just like, it's creepy.
Yeah.
On there. Box.
At least here. Yep. Hard, Sarah.
Okay.
Okay. Words really escaped from there. After they mock, it should run a bit good. But I wanted to say it should run better.
There's a little piece of the center line. Still. Look at Lindsay's position
Marley,
over that
it, Marley,
point.
Take it,
oh my
Marley.
Goodness.
Yeah, really great.
All
really great.
Marley,
yeah,
go.
All of her weight on that point.
And a touch center. Touch center. Good.
Marley, too, and it's, I mean, Marley's very tall. That's not easy. She's got more legs, more arms, everything.
truck. Kate, you gotta go. Her Kate. Hey, good throw.
Good weight.
Katie's looking for the southpaw hit all to the wings.
Really hard. Yep. Whoa.
I like that one. Yeah. Thanks.
So lots of close games out here on sheet one.
Do you like the breeze?
Smith and Adams Moss are tied 2-2 after five.
You can, yeah.
What do you like? Okay, likes to hack. Sarah likes hack.
Okay.
You got it, Sarah.
Hack waits the call for Sarah.
And on sheet eight, Manuel and McDougal are all tied at 3-3 after five. Straightforward for Jessica right now. She'd be happy to just keep this score of 2 in the sixth. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Seeing the weights
really
down.
Hard, Kate. Hard, Katie, hard. You gotta go. Gotta go. I got it.
Good shot.
Thanks.
Yeah.
So for Team Mitchell now, an opportunity to try and hit and roll behind the cover.
You can't go there.
Who does your team play tomorrow?
If they play this, it goes back.
So I'm coaching Team McNutt, who's in this event, and we play Team Hilliard at 9 a.m. tomorrow morning. So I got to get home after this, get to bed, just another early start. And we're also going to be on a feature game on the live stream on Sheet 8. So for those of you tuning in and want to get up and catch another great game tomorrow morning at 9 a.m., we'll see you then.
Mine's good. Where?
Team.
Mine's good.
T-line.
Good.
Hard line, Kate.
Changing gears.
Oh, if they can get this by, this is...
Okay, whoa, you're good.
Oh, what a shot.
Oh, wow.
Very nice.
That was great.
Aggressive call, but it pays off.
What do you see? Put your broom down. Not much. But
yeah. I don't think you can see much. I think this is just a straight peel, too. I don't think they're...
Clean.
Just clean.
Clean. Yep. Clean.
Good throw, Lindsay.
Atta girl.
Nice peel by Lindsay.
Good, Lindsay. Really good.
You're seeing you back commentating tomorrow night?
Take it two.
Okay.
Yes, with one with with the gem. Taylor Stevens is going to join me Thursday night.
Nice.
We're going to commentate.
Nice.
See exactly how far out
Sarah's
she wants this guard.
Sarah!
I like when the holder of the broom holds the, as a sweeper, I like them holding the broom where they want it to go. It's a great visual cue, I think, to say. And especially
okay.
when it's noisy and stuff,
here?
Too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, coming in this close, it makes it
really
a little easier now for.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess I can see the one in the house now to run it back.
Yeah, I mean.
How much of the rock are you hitting?
If it hits the blue one, it's not going to stick. It's going to roam around back there, I think. See that happening. Hmm.
Yeah, it looks like she was just a little full on release
yeah.
and with that kind of lead it's gonna run straight.
Is this turn running the same? Okay. Do you think I throw just like a foot more and let you guys sweep it? Is that a three?
Kate,
right over. Hard, Kate.
Maybe it's not
okay, easy. You're good. You're good.
Should come in nice here for you.
Good throw. Good
well
sweep.
Placed.
Sweep it, we hold it out there.
And Jessica has to blow up the middle. Yeah. I think she needs to play the intern.
Hair low.
Yeah. Number one goal, get that one off the center line. Number two, move the others. Move them around.
Yeah.
I don't think they all go, but you can get rid of two. Boy, it's really fun. I gotta tell you, there are four games out there. They are great games, great shots
Whoa,
being played. Don't come on down to Halifax Grilling Club in the next few days if you want to see some great curling on great ice.
Hurt.
Oh, that was very close.
I like just missed it.
Yep.
You started
Take
talking
the side
and
again.
I started walking away from you. Talking about being overstimulated.
Two?
Yeah, quite a turnaround
yeah.
this end all of a sudden.
Yeah. Enough that it makes it hard.
Team Daigle's on the defense for the first time this game.
I do have a question though. Can you tell? Can we tell who is shot rock, the yellow or the blue? I mean, I think it's
the side is still like running
that,
good.
But
I think so. Yeah, I think it's the same.
Okay.
I think so, but we don't have our overhead cams
yeah.
on the right end.
Switch that.
Three.
I don't really understand technology.
Yes, you will not find Mary Sue on any social media.
That's not true. I'm on Instagram.
How's that dial-up phone still working for you?
So I have a landline, whatever. I have a cell phone too.
Thanks for laughing, Mike.
Hmm. guard wasn't what you wanted it to be. It's not really. It was guarding the out turn.
Yeah, I wonder, is the double there?
I feel like it is. Well.
But then it's jamming on the back blue, I think.
I don't know.
We're going to find out. Looks like she's throwing quieter weight at it with that amount of ice.
Peanut Gallery's commenting on the age of my phone. Whatever, it works.
I really like
this call. is that like a Nokia?
I don't know. How would you know?
It's a no-name.
Okay, Lindsay's saying just a little up. But it looks like nice weight. They're sweeping hard.
They are sweeping hard. She gets by, though.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, she just rubs that.
Okay. Good sweeping.
There's the rock position. Yellow shot rock. Clearly, but no, there was an overhead camera quickly that way. That's the only reason I could tell.
They're going to have a draw no matter what. Yellow shoot hits. I mean, I guess that double's not really there for two.
No. Mm. Here's what you.
They're going to have this to draw to. No,
I think
they
slash that all day. It's hard though.
Sorry,
you lose your shooter. Yeah, I think you throw the guard right now. Yeah, right on the center, like a tight three.
Okay.
And then on my
they're
next gonna,
they're
step.
Gonna
back.
Draw
yeah.
Here for one.
Well, this is
so Mary Sue's daughter.
One.
Katarina has confirmed that Mary Sue's cell phone is older than she is.
Oh, she's on a roll now. It's so old. Guess how old it is. It's pay as you go. It's so old. It's not that old.
Yeah. 10?
Oh, she's making herself laugh, though. That's good.
10? That way.
I do think, like, I don't think you throw the guard because she is going to have a draw to that back blue one. You know, like, she gets an out. I think you're trying to steal here.
10 for the roll under.
I don't know. You could just slightly roll in. That would be a really nice shot here for Mackenzie.
Yeah, that would be ideal.
Yeah, wouldn't it? Yeah. I mean, it really puts a lot of pressure on Jessica if she
Lovely shot.
Sorry.
I hope that was Jim Dandy.
Oh, here she goes. We've got the goose and Jim.
Yeah.
Cooking the goose and Jim Dandy.
Yeah, we'll have to have a little, keep a log. Corny sayings. Yeah, what is Jessica most comfortable with? I get why she's throwing this hit.
Yeah, it's tough to draw against a couple of biters in the forefoot.
Around, you know, especially because you're drawing around a rock. That's the top of the forefoot. You just don't have a lot of space there. Very little room. There's like just an off nose, and you can double it and get one.
What are you guys thinking? I like either one.
Yeah.
Either kind of playing the nose.
Well, Brent McDougal is yelling again, but it didn't work for him.
Swing, but man, still have a
draw for two against McDougal.
Oops, sorry. So Jessica is playing this. The hit
on same type of weight she just threw. It looks like on the ice.
Good, for you know, if you're Mackenzie, you got to be happy with this end. This is a good force, even if they
making her shoot against three.
Yep.
She's got to make a double to score.
And there's a good chance you can get one here with this shot.
Just go back down again.
Oh, they were talking the draw down there.
She threw.
good advice to tell her to go back down and reset.
I like that, and they have time. They're not. They're playing at a nice pace.
No, we got to be playing to play right here.
So Manuel did make his draw for two, so he is now up 5-3 over McDougall after six. And on sheet one, Adams Moss scored two in the sixth end to lead Team Smith 4-2.
And she stole two.
Yeah, for sure, yeah.
Oh, she did steal two.
And on sheet four, it's 5-3, playing the sixth. We're getting down. They just have a few more skip rocks to go.
And that'll be for Team Steel.
I think they're just changing the angle which they're hitting this. That
they're going across the top of it?
Yeah, well, I'm not sure which way they're going, but I think that's what they discussed, which was really good.
And they narrowed up the ice a bit. Maybe they're throwing a little bit more weight at it. Yes, they are.
Good throw. It's a steal for Team Mitchell. One on the board. I mean, that was a nice throw by Jessica. Yeah, I don't know that the overcurl double was really there when you just look at it from this angle.
Had to play quieter weight to get enough of that out.
Yeah, for sure, yeah.
And then that brings potentially the bird into play and giving up three, right? So she kind of did the safer shot to make sure she didn't give up more than one.
That's right. You know what I think she needed? The old lady double. It didn't have to get them all out, but the old lady, this one over there.
A little senior board weight double.
No rock really leaves the rings, but your shooter ends up. You move the rocks enough to score one. So our score in our game is 4-3. Team Daigles takes Hammer to the seventh end.
Kate won't be happy with that. But, always an adjustment that first game, getting used to the speed of the ice.
Yeah, and the curl.
Queen.
Whoa. Nice shot here by Katie.
Very nice.
She throws a lovely rock and really great weight control. I was watching the shape for. Yeah, he was playing the blank and seems to give up one. Instead of taking one, they go a little bit, they're getting cheeky. Although I didn't have a great angle on it, just missed it.
Just one of those little, funny little outside biters.
That's okay.
Good shot. She's got seven.
Very nice.
It's tight, yeah.
I think still like 15 should be close. 14-5 maybe out here.
So they're talking 14-5 to 15 for speed. That's very similar to what the ice was on the first draw today.
Was it? Yeah.
Yeah. Nice and consistent. It held up for the whole game.
Yeah. Lindsay worked that the whole way down, managed that the whole way down. Nice, very nice.
Shout out to the head ice technician, Adam McCarahan, and his ice crew. They've worked tirelessly to produce excellent quality of ice here, and we can look forward to some great shots all week.
I saw an interesting statistic here that Nova Scotia has 33 member clubs within the province.
Line's good!
Sometimes when you're just curling muffle a few weekends ago and you can see they have the names of the curling clubs around and you look around and you see they really are curling clubs all through the province. So even if you're not in Halifax or wherever you are, give it a try. There's a curling club near you.
Mm-hmm.
They're really volunteer focused and you're going to meet some really nice people.
And you may end up in Scotland someday like the Burgess family.
Yeah, you never know. She's playing a bit of a slash here, running her blue back onto the yellow with a really nice hit weight. They do not overthrow. I really like their weight selection. For both teams.
Yes,
and a nice shot.
Ah, very nice.
Yeah, that really accomplished a lot.
Yeah, it was like a 10, eh?
So both teams want to give shout-outs to their sponsors. So for Team Daigle, they'd like to recognize their sponsors Quantum Sport Therapy and Group Fit, and their gold sponsor Burning Flame Candle Company.
Team Mitchell would like to thank their sponsors Neutral On, Wendy's, Black & McDonald, New Scotland Brewing Company, Hardline, and of course, they also want to thank their coach, Mike Callahan.
Yes, Team Daigle's giving a shout out to their coaches, Kevin Willett and Andrew Ling, who are all three coaches for the two teams are seated behind us.
Line's good!
These coaches give a lot of time to the athletes and they train as hard as the athletes do, so shout out to the coaches out there.
Yeah, like you too, Teresa. It's a lot of time. Coaches put a lot of time into their teams.
Yeah, it's lots of fun when you get a chance to work with athletes who are really committed and working to improve and get better. It's really lots of fun.
Perfect draw weight by Kate Callan.
Yeah, lovely shot.
Yeah.
Team Mitchell seems to have found their draw weight, and it's really turning the game around for them.
Yep.
9-5.
And it shows the power of the five rock rule, right? Like it just creates that offense.
Yeah,
that even though Mitchell was down down 3 points, they're now back in the game.
Nice shot by
Marley. Very nice, Marley.
Yeah, gets that off the 4 foot.
Okay.
Nice shot, Yellow sitting too. Yeah. Is this the time if you're Daigle, did you say, you know, I'm gonna draw? I mean, you don't have to worry about keeping another blue rock in play. I like the draw here. I don't see.
Yeah, 14-5.
I'm gonna throw back line if you want. Time out.
Okay, we have a time out. Off go the coaches.
What will they say? I wonder if we can hear them.
Oh, yeah. Let me see if I can turn up the volume here.
I think this is an opportunity for Team Daigle to maybe have two blues up there. I don't want to hit and roll off and give Mitchell another opportunity to draw in behind, even though he'd still have a run back. Anyway, we'll let the... Let's see what these coaches come up with.
Yeah, so our options are you can hit and roll off the back, you can come around draw.
Here's Kevin, so maybe we can turn it up.
There we go. Let's see what he says.
Yeah.
Even that touch bit more on.
Yeah, we seem to have lost that mic. Mm. We could hear him there for a while.
Maybe we can read his lips.
He's talking about the come around seems to be the preferred call. Yeah, I don't know what happened to the mic on the player there that we can't hear them anymore. I got my volume cranked.
Okay, well, they're clear on what they're playing. It's Merle's
like
shot.
14-5. We just got 14-1 on hers.
Yeah.
Or 3, 14-3.
They know what Kate just threw. Using that information. Really similar weight. Oh, not as keen. Like, not the, you know, it seems like at one point they were saying it's 15-5, but 14-5 for sure, which is...
Yeah, I think maybe down the straighter spots it was a little faster.
Yeah.
When you have the big swing, it's coming down a bit.
I wish I had my stopwatch.
Eight, nine.
Does that old phone not have a timer?
It does, actually. It does have a stopwatch on it. It's that fancy. Trying to move this over, but they called it long, and it is just
a little heavy.
Yeah, back line. Yeah. I don't think, yeah. I mean it. I like really grunt.
Here, I think you're good to throw the same. Yeah, okay. Like you've been throwing.
See if I can time
this. Okay. You just want like biting top four Christmas tree?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'd like full four.
Okay.
Yeah, just so that it shrinks it down a little bit more.
Yep.
Okay.
You got it, Max. You got it.
But line is most important,
yes.
So.
Short there would have been good, right?
I'm going to say I don't think you should have been sweeping that. I mean, I don't know. Maybe it was going there anyway, but.
Yeah, when it's heavy, it's heavy.
Yeah, if you've given her
let
the
her die.
Yeah, you've given her the same shot. I wish I knew the times of what they're actually throwing. Be, I'm guessing they're not
great
throwing
14-5. She just threw 14-3.
Ah, thank you.
And the first bat, both of them were 14-3, actually.
There we go.
14-5.
Okay, so those were both 14-3.
Yeah.
So Marley obviously threw more weight than that. But
sure, you got it.
I'd say 14-5 is what you want. Whether I did that right or not, I don't know.
I think you're right, by the way, where it landed.
Yeah. I was reminded of this the other day. I was looking at something.
You could throw the guard
a second.
Throw the guard out and not leave it around.
I think that one's easier, though.
And
isn't
honestly,
it?
Because
that
the
one goes straight into it.
They all go into it. It's just
say
just
from the top. I mean, so kind of like from the top 12 to
up
the
there?
Bottom. Is a bit
different.
Yeah. Okay. When the ice is 14.5, it's always going to be
harder.
This
time.
Okay.
I mean,
so
if I have a bummer, we sink another one.
They're in a bit of the pickle, but
there?
It's kind of
okay.
Up there
and
down.
And a little
just, it's just been some misses.
You got it.
Mm-hmm. I think really Kate's shot where she just.
Are we trying to block?
Yeah.
So do you
set
like
them
like
up. Yeah.
You're getting into the slide
I
pass.
Two.
Here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Make a two.
You're just getting into the slide pad here.
Okay.
It's in the slide pad.
We're probably looking at
a difference
3 feet slower than the path we just did.
Okay.
You got it.
Yeah. You're just calling a long bird?
I believe so.
I think you gotta go.
Yeah, it's really now Daigle's gonna have to make a tap to the forefoot.
Mine only. Sarah, a little bit. We can go. Yep, right, Sarah.
Oh, that's it. Nice weight. Yep. Kate's saying exactly where she wants it.
Yeah, very nice.
Yep, very nice shot. Gotta make this one count. Yeah, so I think a straight raise here, do you think, Teresa? Not.
I think that's what she's calling.
Yeah. It can be tricky calling raise ice, you know? It's just.
Yeah, it's really, it's line and speed, right? So it's much more complex than a straight draw or a straight hit.
Well, and they're not thrown as often, so you just have the same reference points that you do.
This team would practice these, though, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
But again, it's that you're in the first game of the event, so you're still learning the ice, so it.
Yeah.
Just more complex than she would be like to have to throw right now.
This is cool. Looks nice.
They're calling heavy.
I think the weight was okay, but I think it's the angle.
Really nice weight.
Yeah.
Oh. Great weight. They just
that's
didn't need to get off of it. If they stayed on it, they might have held the line.
It's a steal.
Yeah. Steal a two.
Yeah.
Okay, we have
Mitchell
quite a game going.
We do. Mitchell takes the lead here. Jane is listening to us, Teresa? I mean, what else would she
I
be doing?
I hope so.
Yeah, I mean, really.
Shout out to our
our teammate. Our teammate.
Yes. Jane Flynn Burton, who has organized the commentators for this event. Hence why we are here. Thank you, Jane.
Thank you, Jane. Jane always makes sure we get good games, so don't tell anyone. But all the games are great. Honestly, when you look at all these games are so close, and there's so many great shots being made.
We have the best of the best, right? These are the top eight men's and eight women's teams in the province.
And you know what we're in now? We're in the eighth end, which is such an important game and a time game. This is where the rubber hits the road. I'm ashamed to say I use that one way too often.
Only if you can.
14-2. That's a classic, Mary Sue.
Really good. Yeah, so Mitchell's
an oldie but a goodie.
Yeah, nice shot by Kate. Exactly where she wanted that to be.
Kate's dialed in on her draw weight now.
Both teams are just looking at the time. Mitchell has more time than Daigle, but they both have enough time. But they do. The Daigle team will just want to be aware of their time.
So update on sheet four. Team Thompson is making a comeback here and has tied the game at 5-5 versus Team Steele. So we've got an exciting finish coming up. They're playing the eighth end as well.
Yeah, and actually all the games are in the eighth end.
Amazing what time clocks do to keep the pace going.
They
really
do.
Time clocks.
Yeah.
Shout out to our timekeepers.
Oh my goodness.
Ooh, who is that? That was a good yell.
That was Colton Steele.
Mine's good.
There's some Dartmouth boys over there in sheet four.
Mine's good.
Oh, I think Andy Ganesh takes claim to Robbie McLean.
Kate, you gotta go.
Ah, yes.
Right over. Hard, Kate.
Right over, Kate.
Hard.
Yep.
Right over. Good sweep.
And nice guard.
Yeah.
Well placed, nice and tight to the house.
Yep. Daigle's going to use her corner guard.
So sheet one, Team Smith scored one in the seventh end, so they trail Team Adams Moss by a score of 4-3, playing eight.
But they do look like they have some blues in there right now. We
can't
tell exactly.
Smith has got something going here. Sheet 8, Manuel is up 5-4 on McDougal with hammer.
That was a great shot by Katie. And great sweep.
Wow, very nice.
Yeah, Lindsay and Marley, they're really...
Perfectly bearing.
Yeah.
You got it.
It's also really nice top 8 foot. That's exactly where you want it.
Okay, I haven't heard from our teammate Jane. I don't think she's watching. Maybe she's fallen asleep.
Mm-hmm. Maybe Carrie's watching.
Kate,
in Glasgow, you never know.
Hard.
From Pictou County.
Hard! Hard, Kate! Hard!
Haven't heard from her either.
Okay, whoa.
Okay,
Kate. Oh, that was so close to getting around.
I know.
Nice wait.
Guess if they had
you got it.
Yeah. Just hit and roll out there for Lindsay. Not what she was trying to do there.
Like hit and roll the corner, the hit to center? Yeah.
Hey, you're coming here.
Okay, looking for bringing it in. Christmas tree action on that.
I thought your weight was real good.
Team Smith has a draw for four on sheet one. I don't know who is hammer. Oh, she doesn't have hammer, sorry. All right. Don't listen to me.
Wait only.
Frozen. This one really seems to be hanging out there.
Take it behind. Yeah.
Whoa.
Okay. Are you trying to get a bind? I think that would be your best team.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. There's a, it's a good shot.
Yeah, they made the most of that. Wasn't what they had called.
Really, I don't think. Although it is Lindsay's shot, yeah. I do actually have a question, Miss Colin. I wonder if you don't have to.
Should finish a bit at the end. Yeah.
Make the play on the top forefront. And just roll to the side a bit. Oh, that was a really nice shot. Nice shot, Lindsay Bridges. Nice.
Didn't get rid of the guard, though, on the center guard. So she would have liked to roll more towards the corner, but.
Yeah, she wouldn't have made the double.
At least
she
the guard now
that.
Is.
Yeah.
At least the guard now is theirs.
Kate Callahan has got her draw weight in her back pocket, so she's going to.
She does.
Yeah. She can do with it.
If you can.
Right? It's just fine as it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Great shot, Kate. Yeah. I know. Jessie's really trying to get that shot in play. Trying to keep her blue rock over there in the mix.
Thanks for the shout out from Jen Krause, who was watching. Hope to see you down here at the club this weekend, Jen.
I saw the Jen Krause earrings at the curling store. Oh, that was a great shot by Molly.
Jen does make some awesome earrings. So check them out next time you're in the curling store for the latest, greatest curling equipment.
Yeah.
10-5.
That was a really nice throw by Molly. It sets up the jam too on the blue and the yellow.
Think that's close?
Yeah, really interesting end we have going here.
Yeah.
Lots of good shots.
Yeah, Mackenzie's going for it too. She's not sitting back. To curl.
Okay, whoa.
And not to jam it. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, that was the danger there. I do think you gotta deal with this because it is sharp rock.
Sure,
so.
Okay.
Yeah, good up setup. Good setup now for Team Daigle.
Yeah, it really turns that end around, doesn't it? It's really Marley shot that. Is
nice
a difference 10, maker.
Five. Clean.
I think that might roll out though, yeah.
Wow, that just didn't curl at all.
To have you on it.
Maybe a little bit more weight than they wanted.
You come around or you try to chase?
Okay, she's gonna have to go. Yeah. It's all blue, so.
How much?
Put your arm down.
Like enough to do that?
Yeah, I know. Here you go.
Those are all buried.
That's what Sophia would do.
I think you can get to it.
maybe I have an idea.
Yeah, like, okay.
Maybe.
Let's check with Sophia.
Like here?
Yeah.
It should curl.
This is, yeah. Well, it's eighth end.
Okay. Well, I mean,
as I say, put your big girl panties on and deal with it, right?
Board? It should move.
Yeah.
Like a lot.
I agree.
Commit to the shot.
Yes, exactly.
Board?
It will curl. She stated that was a good reminder to herself.
Yeah.
It will curl.
Yeah.
Just trust your brain and
yeah, I'm kind of seeing hack from here.
Use your sweepers.
Yeah. Same sheet one that Smith stole one in the eighth, but I do think that Jocelyn was drawing against four.
I think so.
So she must have made a good draw.
Yeah.
Yeah, so all tied up on sheet one. Smith versus Adams Mons playing nine. So we got a big finish coming up there.
There.
And Manuel just playing to the eighth end.
Okay. So Manuel's up one with playing nine.
This half is still going to be good.
Okay. Pack?
Yeah.
The time clock's here. We're both at 9 minutes now, which is plenty of time for two ends.
Surprised with that weight she threw.
Yeah,
it looked a little
throwing
light.
More.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
That is. That's just. Oh.
Where do you want it? Yeah.
Oh.
In case they make that.
Apparently, what Sophia says is that she would say, that's a perfect idea. Maybe I have a perfect idea.
Yeah.
Where did she learn that from?
Don't draw for Jessica. Taken plenty of ice, so shouldn't be a problem.
Five. Yeah, we need off. Yeah. Switch. Wayne's guy.
Wayne's nice. Took a good shot.
Good.
She would have liked it a little deeper, but I do think she has to play the hit and roll. Don't you? What do you think, Teresa? Do you think Mackenzie has to play the hit? I think she has to play the hit and roll or the intern draw.
I think you have to do that to get
it. Yeah, so she's up one right now.
Yeah,
so
I agree.
She could hold them to two.
Well, you're
going to
be like here, but that's fine.
Yeah, that's fine.
I mean, you can't afford to give up four, so playing the draw puts four in play.
Yeah.
I'm seeing 10.
It's true.
Because I think you need enough to get the roll.
Playing the hit, worst case is 3.
There, 10.
Yeah, you do have to roll. But, they're throwing nice. They're all throwing nice weights, so. That doesn't seem to have been a problem today. You know, sometimes you can see struggle with
10.
Hits and rolls, and there's no roll. It's just the hit.
I forgot they were sitting one at the back. They're already sitting four.
I didn't
see that blue rock at the back. It was behind my TV screen. Yeah. Might be tempted to play the draw, actually. But yeah, she makes a nice hit and roll here. They've certainly thrown a pile of rocks down here. They should know what it does. This is curling.
Yeah. She's having trouble with that intro.
She is. It's just a little soft.
Yeah.
Just needs to give herself a little bit more ice for her throw.
Yeah, compared to other people's, exactly. She gets more curl with it. Jessica can throw the same shot, and she'll get four.
Okay, so. So over on sheet four, we have an update. So Team Thompson has stolen another one, and they have taken the lead over Team Steel.
Interesting scoreboard, 5-6-7, hey, no, they're on the bottom.
So the score is 6-5 now for Thompson playing the ninth in.
Just bringing this in.
Hey, big score of 4 for Team Daigle.
And really, like, he didn't see that happening either. It was
Yeah, just
yeah,
a little bit unfortunate.
Yeah. That's a situation where those back-to-back misses hurt you. You know, like if you have, you can have one miss, but then you can't have the next miss. You
yeah,
know?
You got to make the next yeah. one.
So Team Daigle is up, going to be up 3 playing the ninth end. And for Team Mitchell, you just got to focus on getting that 2.
Yeah, with the 5-rock free guard zone, no tick zone. Yeah, they're not out of this game yet. Lots of discussion on sheet 8 on the Manuel McDougall game. They've had several team conferences in the houses, so we'll see what's. We'll keep you updated on what's going on there. It's not really that many rocks in the house in play, but they've discussed a lot.
Brent is yelling, though.
Brent's not going to have a voice.
Fitzgerald.
Line's tight. Line's
Kate
good.
Kate is taking her science degree at Dalhousie.
As far as it'll go. Okay. Good.
Good guard by Kate. Katie, Kate and Katie. It's looking for a T-line here, I think. It doesn't weigh in. She was just a little deep on her first one, but that's okay. It's possible, you know. Ooh,
there.
My goodness.
Do you want to throw that one?
The question is 2 corner guards or.
I like this, I think. We can go here.
We're only guaranteeing ourselves.
Whatever you do, you have to have separation.
Not 3, we need to throw the other corner.
They're saying the 2 corner guards, don't you think, Teresa? Yeah.
I think
this
so.
Decision by the ice.
Yep.
I like the 2 corner guards. They're down. They've got a. And those 2 blue rocks in the house aren't in a great spot.
Yeah, I think they're going to try and go hard for their 3 to tie it up.
Yeah.
It's got a curl. Right over.
Okay. Nice shot.
Good.
Nice shot.
Should just curl nice here, eh?
Little bump here for Lindsay Burgess. Because that's Brent. You can really hear Brent. Just looking to bump this blue up a bit. Scotty. Hmm. It's not a bad setup for Team Mitchell. Yep. Yeah, I don't think putting another rock in the rings is of any benefit to Jessica. Here comes the peeler. She's trying. Oh, good try.
Yep. All good.
Second shot at this end. It's a little more
relaxed. Good. Stay close. Top four. Coming off.
Whoa.
Top four.
Close. It's got to curl.
I think it will.
Right over. Hard.
Really curls
nicely. Right over
there.
As far as it'll go. Mm-hmm. Go, 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 go.
Look at that. Very nice
shot. Keep it moving. Oh, that's perfect.
Yeah, very nice.
Yeah.
Yeah,
sure.
Wow. And Jessica's happy to just peel and
yep.
Hopefully limit them to two. Be one up coming home with a hammer.
Straight peel here. Good, atta girl.
Nice shot.
Here's that guard. Yeah. Use the intern. First of all, it does curl and then limit the opportunity for a double.
Yeah. Yeah.
Spread your rocks out and then group them. Okay, well, on sheet one, in the ninth end, Adams Moss got one, so they are on 1-5-4. Playing the 10th end.
Is this Kate's
big
first?
Finish coming up.
Yeah, all okay. These teams. And the other three sheets are just finishing up their,
I'm good with that.
Their ninth ends.
Yeah. Okay.
Using the same, yeah.
Whoa, yep. Whoa. No.
Looks
sit.
Good. Yep.
Sit, 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 sit.
Nice shot. Good. It's a good shot.
She might have overcurled a hand.
She can't see it. Just looking at the angle from here.
Yeah, but if we get the guard, that's okay.
Yeah. the same shot from Marley that she just threw. I love how low Katie is on her broom.
Atta girl. Oh, great shot. Fun.
Yeah.
Nice throw.
And around the corner, girl. There's a pattern here.
Line's good.
It's the late curl once it comes off the line.
Line's good.
Perfect. It's perfectly buried. I'm just gonna ignore it. Because it's second shot, I think, is the thinking there.
Yeah.
That's why, yeah, I'm not sure you had to go crazy there on the.
Yeah, you need it to be make shot because it's very difficult to get that blue one.
Yeah, because you're always gonna have the risk of that jam, yeah. Oh, the young people, Teresa. Oh, that was nice.
Watching him sweep is wearing me out.
Yeah, I know. Oi, look how low she gets on the broom.
Sweeping.
That was terrific sweeping. I didn't think I was going to get to the house. Yeah. I think you got
right. Go. Yeah, I think so.
Right around the hall.
There?
Yeah. Yeah, you draw around the blue staggered rocks.
Yeah. Still got a good chance for two if you can get this one in nicely positioned.
You could play that in turn
sink
again,
it.
But she could just go around the center, so you're still
a little slower.
Okay.
So like the 14-2 you got on Kate's, that's probably pretty close to the top four.
Okay.
You got it.
Great shot.
Did that ever die, huh?
Wow.
Holy smoke. I didn't.
Yeah.
That's a perfect.
They were yelling back eight.
Yeah.
Beautiful shot.
Yeah.
But Jessica just needs to come down, and anywhere in front of that, and it's going to be challenging to get her deuce.
Yeah, but she does need to get to the forefoot because Kenzie can play that wide in turn.
That's true.
Yep. Edge of the forefoot.
Yeah, exactly.
This is Jessica's last rock of the ninth end.
This is a nice
point.
Yep.
Go.
Calling 6-7.
Go.
The weight's coming off it as well, but
yeah.
Go, 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 go,
get
go, go,
it to the forefoot. Very
that's
nice.
A good shot, yeah.
Atta
girl. Nice shot.
You definitely can see that.
Couldn't bounce. So
that's a takeaway for your team too. Note that later in the game, you know, the slide, which is typical, but the slide path in the 4 foot line is just a little bit heavier. This should be a nice path out here.
Yeah, it should be.
She's really not getting into that slide path. She's staying out there.
I said it would mess with my mojo if I had to.
One more time.
I'll tell you.
So chunk of 4 foot. Nice
piece. This path is running better.
Okay. Yeah. This should be like normal.
Yeah.
Okay.
You got it. You got
Kate gives Mackenzie great information on the sweeping paths.
Just one for Team Mitchell, so they're going to be down two without playing the 10th end. So they've got their work cut out for them, but they make all their shots, and they just need a few mistakes from the other team, and they'll have a chance.
We've got great look on sheet four. They're playing the 10th end, and it's a tie game. And Stuart Thompson has hammer. And what's, no one calls him that anymore. Matt Manuel. Is that his hammer? Is that his hammer? Because if it is, he's hitting for four, I think. Oh my goodness, you didn't.
Oh dear. From 4-2. Okay. Manuel scores 2, so they're up 3 playing 10.
All right, so Kate, these guys are looking for double guards for sure, so the question is.
Mine's good.
Higher tight.
Just had a honk rock on sheet 4, unfortunately. Oh,
really? Okay.
For Team Steel.
Kate, if you can.
They still have a guard up, so.
Kate.
Kate's rock. She's got
the high one. She's got the center line. So this is where we'll see if the center line. Yeah, and Jessica's going to the open side. She could throw this through. You're up to a hammer. Mostly just. So if you peel, you don't have any jamming, but.
Yeah, not really sure what the advantage would be to draw to the wing here. You don't need to score any points, you just need to.
Yeah, this is short.
Prevent points.
Hard, guys!
I'd probably be more tempted to play top 4 or throw it through.
Yeah. I'm not sure if I would play that to the wing.
Mine's good! Yep! Whoa, really? Mine's good.
Mine's nice, just trying to get it tight.
Got
this
it,
looks
girl.
Really nice.
Yeah, very nice.
Really nice, Kate. Really nice. Come on.
Oh.
Okay.
That's a good shot.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
A piece, but.
Yeah, but you can't hit that top one.
I probably gotta have to throw it back line.
On the front.
Yeah.
That That's, yeah, you know what I...
Mm-hmm. Not sure if she was a little soft on that or just made more ice, but that's the thing with this no-tick rule in the center line. Like, you need to give enough ice. So
yeah. She did ask for just through. I think her weight was fine.
Perfect shots,
yeah.
Really.
And there's
yeah,
no
it's very difficult double.
Yeah, no. No natural double peel there.
Here goes Lindsay with her peels.
That was a good shot.
Yeah.
Good, Lindsay.
Yeah.
Right
oh my goodness, Colton Steele's team had another hog. I don't know.
You got it, Sarah.
They didn't look like they were sweeping at the whole way either.
Did I pick something?
No, I think it just ran. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Shaders last shot at the send.
It's gotta come on.
Okay.
See if it dies once it gets the 4 foot.
It's fine.
It's fine too.
Yeah. It's a great line.
Good shot.
Just. Lindsay again with the whole peel. I like how she doesn't, she's not throwing an incredible amount of weight. It's just well thrown. Oh, nice. That's a good result. That's a good result.
Yeah, good shot.
Yeah.
By the second to Lindsay Burgess. It's now becoming a little more difficult to steal two.
Yeah.
Do we want to call a time?
Okay.
Look at it, they're calling a timeout. There we go. Good. I think this is good timing for a timeout, too. Yeah. Coach is putting down his. He's getting out there.
If you lock it on here, they just straight peel, right?
I think this is a really good time for a timeout. Steele's rink has no rocks out front, so
yeah. I'm just thinking that
Thompson
either
has two
way.
Rocks in the house. Yeah. I'll listen to these ladies.
So what do you think?
Well, they're
we have threes. They just rip the guard.
Yeah.
But if we dead freeze it and keep throwing that guard, we make that guard. We're either freezing, throwing the guard, or throwing like back line at the seven. And
I don't think we do that yet.
I don't like the hit
yeah,
and roll. I don't like hit and roll because if the option is you probably get yourself out of play.
Yeah.
I don't mind. I don't know if you need to freeze right now. But what if you get one even in the way up here? She's playing the run through no matter what.
Yeah.
Right? So if you get one in the way and she plays the peel and jams this.
So, like top 12?
I don't mind top 12.
Like top 8?
Top 8, top 12.
Yeah, okay.
I don't think you need to freeze it.
So if we do
what turn?
Deal with this
whatever
one.
Turn you're comfortable with.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep. Okay.
So where do you want it?
Like, right here?
Okay.
Yeah, I'm never playing the hit here. Teresa, what do you think? Okay. I mean, I like this call because I'm not sure what else you do. I don't know if you can set it up so that if you...
Yeah, I mean, I think they've got to come around, try and lay two, and then hopefully guard for their life.
Wait only.
Mine's a little tight.
Yeah. If you can... Nice.
Oh yeah, this is a great shot.
This is great. Oh man, Kate has made a lot of great shots.
Yep.
Okay.
She's just a little light.
Noticed how many Kates we have.
Still a great shot.
And they're all spelled differently, Katie and Kate. Yeah. That's a great shot. She made some key draws.
Mm-hmm.
Feel for Merle.
Yep.
Not trying to do anything too much here. Nice throw. Colton Steele is playing a little freezy tappy. Guard here for Kate.
Action on all four sheets.
I know it is.
We're like trying to follow them all.
I know, it's exciting.
It's amazing everybody is playing at almost the exact same pace.
They really are. Yeah.
I've never seen that before.
No, it's true. You don't usually see. Well, that's a tiny bit close, but the line is great. A lot of sweeping going on out there. On the Smith rink, they're trying to score two. They're sitting one. Jocelyn
just made a nice
shot. She did make a nice shot, yeah.
So forcing Jill to have to go wide and try and catch a corner of the forefoot for her deuce.
Yeah. She catches a corner of the
It's there.
Yep.
If not, we're going to an extra.
Okay, here comes Marley throwing the... These are tight enough to play the double pin.
Yeah, that guard just came a little tight. She's
going to...
Nice
throw by Marley.
This looks good.
Oh, man. I thought she had that.
I did, too.
Yeah.
Oh,
nice throw.
Wow. Jill's close here. She's close.
Put on this? Yeah. Is that the call?
It just overcurled.
Okay.
She's a little light too. I think that looks like an extra
end. An extra end on sheet one.
We don't have time to really discuss. I think
you go tight. Yeah, tight.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I was just looking at the time. These guys have a minute and over a minute and a half left, so. They know what they want to play.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not
halfway guard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Really sure why.
Sarah. Low, easy.
This looks good.
Yeah.
Kate.
It's nice.
Yeah. Perfect.
Yeah. You can't.
So, your options are.
Yeah.
You could, if you peel the guard.
She's going to hit your blue.
Yeah, and then you're going to have a double for the win, right?
Yeah.
Lock on. Perfect.
right now you're sitting second shot, and she'd have to deal with it.
Mm-hmm.
I like this shot. I like this call.
Just behind the tee line.
Oh my goodness. He almost missed that. Stuart Thompson did win, but I'm going to tell you, that was close.
Okay, so we have our first finish. Actually, we have two finishes. So, sheet 8, Manuel has defeated McDougall, and on sheet 4, Thompson has defeated Steele.
8-9! 9!
Yeah, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Okay, they
hold
think
it.
It's
hold it. Nine.
Deep in the house then.
You gotta go. Gotta go, keep going, keep going. Keep going. Push, 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 you got it, you got it. Push, 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 push.
Looks good if they can get it by.
Great. I love how Katie.
Yeah, really good sweep.
What's this? Okay, timeout. The last timeout. Well,
yeah.
I think we're going to have to draw.
I think you have to draw right on the top of the yellow.
Yeah, it's fine. He can come.
Because there's
wants.
No.
I think it's just a straight draw, though.
I think
just
it's
listen
draw
to the players. They seem to be
no.
agreeing on the draw, but
yeah.
just double checking.
Just being careful with their time too, because they'd have a minute and a half left.
This way?
Yeah, I like. I'm gonna agree with Mike. I like the outturn draw too. I do not like the intern draw here.
This is the slower path, though.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Whatever you're seeing, if you're seeing
this.
Yeah, I mean, you can play either turn.
I like this.
Okay.
Right here?
Yep.
I think there are just a few more options there. Yeah, it's tight, but you rub off that blue and you scooch over. You scooch over, Teresa. She's in trouble.
I'm good with this.
In fact, you could almost play the scooch.
Just stay really close.
The scooch
close.
Is in play.
Yeah.
Like a smidgen.
Yeah.
like
a redirect.
Yeah.
Like yeah, she gets through this port.
Yeah. yeah.
Obviously, we're going
I think it's worth it.
Jessica's going to have a tough last shot.
Yeah. Jessica had the weight just in quite of a line. It did.
Okay. Yeah. Is it the same?
Oh, there's they're screaming on sheet one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh my. Okay, here we go. She's not heavy. Yeah, I feel like she's light.
Hi!
Yeah, that's going to over-curl, I think. Yeah.
See, one reason if you played this way, you had the flexibility to be a little bit heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you know what? That was a good game.
It was a good game.
It's a good game. Thanks for watching, and make sure to tune in at future live streams or come down to the Halifax Curling Club yourself. Anyway.
Hope to see you here.
Yeah.
Thanks for joining us.
Thanks. See ya. Bye now.
Have a good night.